Hi, I'm Mr. Beats. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. In this video, we will review how comparative advantage drives international trade in the Ricardian trade model. The Ricardian model predicts how goods are exchanged between countries based on the comparative advantage of the trading parties. Its implication was groundbreaking. Any country benefits from trade independently of its economic position. Let's see why that is the case in an example with two countries trading in two goods. Suppose there are two countries, country A and country B, and two products, oranges and apples. Assume that both countries have the same number of equally capable farmers and the same amount of land. But country A's climate is better suited for apples, and country B's climate is better for oranges. If country A were to grow only apples, it would produce 40 apples a day. If it specialized in oranges, it could only produce 10 oranges a day. For country B, it is the other way around. Let's assume their production possibilities frontier is linear, as in these graphs. In the absence of trade, called autarky, one cannot consume more than what one produces, so consumption is limited to the combinations of apples and oranges to the left of the PPF in green. All combinations to the right of the PPF, the red area, are unattainable. What happens if the two countries were to trade? Each country would specialize in the activity for which it has the lower opportunity cost of production. This is called a comparative advantage. Country A's opportunity cost of producing one orange is four apples. That is how many apples the country needs to give up to produce one orange. In country B, the opportunity cost of producing one orange is a fourth of an apple. Since the opportunity cost is higher in country A, country B has a comparative advantage in growing oranges. It is the opposite for apples. The opportunity cost of producing one apple in country B is four oranges, while in country A, it is a fourth of an orange. Country A has a comparative advantage in growing apples. Both countries are better off by specializing in the activity for which they have a comparative advantage, and then trading between them. Let's see why that is the case. With complete specialization, there are 40 oranges and 40 apples on the market. That is more than what was available before. The country's consumption frontier expands beyond their production possibilities frontier, all the way to the blue line. If they trade one orange for an apple, they could end up consuming 20 apples and 20 oranges, which was unfeasible in the absence of trade. These are the gains of trade. Both countries' well-being has improved compared to autarky. This completes our review of the Ricardian theory of trade. Visit us at Chegg for more videos on this and on other topics, or to speak with a subject matter expert. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.